Carl Froch, George Groves, the rematch, sold already 80,000 tickets. Who says boxing is hurting when you sell? Mayweather's fight sold out in 10 minutes.
Boxing's alive and well, Sekbek. And this is a dope fight. This is a good British showdown rematch. Controversial stoppage the first time. And drama and intrigue and Carl Froch, the established guy, and Groves, the guy who wants to be there and thinks he can, had Iron Chin Froch down and was giving him all sorts of problems. Froch seemed to have weathered the storm and was coming on, and an overzealous referee brings us to a beautiful rematch. Yeah, that sold out 80,000 seats in like 5 minutes or something. And you know what? The Brits always support their champions, and that's cool. And I want to see something like that happen in the good old USA.
Who could do over here 80,000? Mayweather against anybody?
Who knows?
Yeah. Mayweather Pacquiao?
Dallas Cowboys Stadium, probably.
Yeah, 120,000.
Yeah. I like that.
Maybe that's
again,
it.
Like he said, they support fighting over there. They support boxing overseas. They support it in England. They support it in Klitschko's goal and fight. They support it over there. Just here, we got so many different sports that, you know, most people, even with sporting events nowadays, a lot of people are going just to get seen anyway. Like,
yeah,
you look at NBA games.
Like, show up at a quarter late, leave a quarter early.
Celebrities sitting out on is they have no interest in the actual game.
Do people still go to Laker games?
Yeah, I guess they do.
No, even Lakers don't show up to Laker games.
Yeah.
But again, but like it's just showing you over there, they're supporting, they still supporting boxing. It's still exciting to them. I mean, you saw whenever they had somebody from over there come over here and fight, like when our Ricky Hatton used to fight over here, you'd have a big contingency from the UK come over here to support him.
But you know what's crazy though? We all know Carl Froch.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
A lot of people that I talk to have no idea who George Groves is. None. Like, they don't know what he looks like. They don't know his record. We all know Froch. We all know his girlfriend.
Well, Froch, you know, was in that position before the start of the Super Six and needed an opportunity to springboard himself onto the international scene.
So Super Six made all the difference.
Yeah, it really did. And look, hey, a win from George Groves gets him seen on the world stage as well, and then everybody's talking about him. So this is how the game is played.
Mm-hmm. Okay. The Martinez-Cotto fight sold out pretty much 85% in 10 minutes. The Mayweather-Maidana fight sold out faster than that. They could have done that in a stadium. That fight has a lot of interest with it. And then there's another fight in England, Tyson Fury against Derek Chisora.
Yeah, I don't really understand that rematch, but whatever.
Keep Tyson Fury busy.
Okay, yeah. I didn't know that the fight was that competitive the first time.
You saw it this week. He flipped the table in a press conference.
Thing,
he got all mad.
He can't do it. He can't do it because he really doesn't have any boxing skill. But
he sells
because he's you know, knows how to sell a fight just from what his talking and this and whatnot.
He self-promotes.
But that's what boxing needs sometimes.
Heavyweight's dead.
Not the division's back now.
Boxing needs heavyweights that can actually box. That's what we need, because then the fights are going to sell it, not, and you don't have to resort to all these like other shenanigans and everything. All
right, so who wins, Froch or Groves?
I like the Cobra. He brings the veteran experience into the ring. He kind of tasted what Groves had to offer the first time. Maybe he didn't think he was capable of putting him down or hurting him. I think he's definitely going to respect him now, and Groves is going to have to bring himself to a new level.
Yeah, I think so as well too. Carl Froch, when he has a rematch, he always looks better in the rematch. He looks better in the rematch against Mikko Kessler. And when their first fight was a very, very close fight, it was. And you know what? He may come out in this fight a lot smarter as well too. You know, a lot of people, they like to say like, oh, Froch was getting his ass kicked in the first fight. First off, he got knocked down in the first round. He did lose some of those rounds in the beginning, but he started finding his ground, and he was coming back in some moments, and he was landing some good shots of his own. The stoppage was definitely bullshit. I agree with that, definitely. But that's what makes this rematch so intriguing, is that at a moment where it seemed like Carl Froch was starting to come back, the ref decided to jump in and stop it, when we all know that Groves was still fine and able to still fight, definitely. So that's what makes it an interesting fight. But, you know, I know there's a lot of Brits out there that are really, really pulling for Groves to pull the upset. But right now, at this moment, I think I'm going to have to favor Carl Froch. Just based on the fact that, like Brandon said, he's had a taste of what Groves brings now. He'll be smarter the second time around.
Okay, Coach?
Carl Froch is one of those guys you don't want to give, you know,
a second
fight to, because he'll adjust. Carl Froch is one of those fighters that his mentality, he's going to do what it takes to win the fight. You know, that's what he wants to do. He wants to win, so he's going to come in with the mentality to win. He's going to do everything it takes to win. He's going to make the adjustments.
Bring him in.
And I think he's going to, and plus he's a guy that walks around with a little bit of a chip on his shoulder, so he wants to prove to everybody that, you know, he's number one. So he's going to come in and show everybody what he's got. So I'm taking Carl Froch.
So there you have it. 80,000 people are pumped up for this.
I don't blame you.
Froch Groves. You won't want to miss it. The fight's going down May 31st, and it's going to be on HBO?
HBO, yes, it'll be on HBO. Luckily for us over here in the U.S., we'll be able to see it on TV. It was unfortunate for us that it wasn't televised the first time. Us U.S. fans over here had to stream it, but it's good to know that it'll be on HBO. And good exposure for Carl Froch and George Groves here in the States.
I'm going to try to make it to that one. Sounds like a good one. Face100.com and Vice Impact reporting.